this video, we're going to talk about dynamic input. And so what is dynamic input? If we look down here at our status bar, we've got this little icon right here, dynamic mode. So this is dynamic input. It's turned off right now because it's not blue. If I turn it on, it's blue now. I can click on these three lines right here. If you don't see it, I can go to my customization and I can put a little check mark next to dynamic input. And that's how I get that icon down there. So if you don't see it, you can make sure that this is checked in your customization. Now I'm going to draw a line and I'm going to show you what dynamic input looks like. So it's talking to me right there at the cursor. Dynamic input it showed up in release 2006. And so it's been quite a while that we've had dynamic input available to us. And before 2006, what we had to do is just read the command line. We were constantly saying, what does the command line say? Read the command line, look at the command line. So the nice thing is they took all the information. It's still prompting me at the command line, which is that white bar down at the bottom where it says line, specify first point. But now it's also talking to me right there at the cursor. So I don't have to constantly look down away from my drawing. My eyes can stay on my drawing and right where my cursor is. So it's telling me what it needs me to do. It wants me to specify the first point. So specify the next point. I've already locked down this point. This is called the rubber band effect. And so I have locked down one edge of this. Now it doesn't know where I want to go from here. So do I want to go at an angle? Do I want to go at a specific point at my X comma Y? So lots of different options that we have here. I could just click somewhere and be done with the line command, but I'm gonna erase that and I'm gonna back it up. We're gonna do a line command and we will start with an absolute coordinate of 2, 2. Wherever that is, I'm typing 2, 2. Oop, let's go find where that is. There we go, there's my 2, 2. So as I'm drawing now that I've started at 2, 2, it doesn't know where I want my next point to be. So I could just click anywhere like I did the last time, or I can type in another coordinate. So if I type in, let's go 3, 3, or let's go 2, 3. So we're supposed to go over 2 and up 3. 2, 3. Press enter. And look what it did. It started at this point, went over 2, and it went up 3. That is what's called a relative coordinate. So it is by default choosing to do a relative coordinate. It did not start at 0, 0 and go over 2 and up 3. Let's do it. Actually, let me show you this. I kind of made this little cheat sheet here. So we were doing an absolute coordinate with dynamic on. If I want to do an absolute coordinate, I'm going to have to press the pound sign before I type X comma Y. If I just type X comma Y, it assumes that what I'm going to do is a relative coordinate, which is what it did. So I have dynamic on. If I want it to be an absolute coordinate, I press pound sign before X, Y, or I can just assume that that coordinate that I type in, it's just going to assume that I want it to be a relative coordinate. So coming back here, we'll do the line command again, and I'll start at the same place. So 2, 2. Oops. Press enter. It's the same starting point, but if I type in pound sign to tell it I want it to be an absolute coordinate right now, then I can type in 2, 3. So it'll start at 0 and go over 2, up 3. And there it is. So it went over 2. So it's a straight line because they're both 2, but it went up a distance of 3. So this line versus that line is the difference between an absolute coordinate and a relative coordinate. This absolute coordinate started at 0, went over 2, up 3, started at 0, starting, that starting point was at 2, 2 from 0. This one was, again, it started off at 2, 2 from 0, but once you have that first point, it assumed that I wanted to go over 2, up 3, relative to that first point that I had just given it. So when you have dynamic on, it assumes that you're wanting to do a relative coordinate. Let's back it up and let's do it with the dynamic turned off. So I'll come over here and let's leave this one here. We'll just use different coordinates this time. So I've got my dynamic turned off. I'm going to do a line command. Notice it's not prompting me at the cursor, so there's no dynamic input on here. It wants my first point, so I will type 5, 5. Enter. So it came over from 0, over 5, and up 5. It wants my next point, and if I type in 7, 7, it's going to assume that I'm talking about an absolute coordinate. It's going to come from 0, 0, and it's going to go over 7 and up 7 from that origin. Press enter, and there we go. I've drawn this line right here. This point is at absolute 7, 7. I'm going to do the same thing, and I will start at 5, 5. But this time, if I want it to be a relative coordinate, so relative to this point, to go over 7 and then up 7, if I have my dynamic turned off, I need to type the at symbol first. So this is the way we always used to do it. It assumed you wanted an absolute coordinate. If you wanted a relative coordinate, you had to type the at symbol, 7, 7. Press enter, and look what it did. It went from this point over 7 and up 7. So that would be a relative coordinate. So with dynamic turned off, I had to type in the at symbol to get it to be relative. It was assuming I wanted absolute, which is the complete opposite of having the dynamic on. Now let's look at polar coordinates. Now you know polar coordinates are anything that have an angle to it. It's any coordinate when you're dealing with an angled line. With dynamic on, it's really easy to do. You just type in the length, you press tab, and you type in the angle. When you have dynamic off, you have to type in the at symbol. Again, remember that at symbol tells it it's relative to that last point. Then you give it the length. Then you type in an angle symbol, and this is just letting it know, hey, there's an angle coming, and then you type in whatever that angle is. So let's do it both ways. So I'll turn on my dynamic. We'll draw a line, bring it down here, and notice I clicked wherever to start. You could type a coordinate if you needed to, but notice here I've got my dynamic on, so I just have to type in my length, so I'll type in a length of 5. When I press tab, it locks me into a length of 5. Now it wants to know what my angle is. So here I can type in 45. When I press enter, I just drew a line. It's a length of 5 and it's at an angle of 45 degrees. If I turn off my polar the way that we used to do this, start that same line command, click to start. I had to, from this point, I had to tell it, I want to go relative. So relative to that last point that I just gave you, 5 is my length. And then I'm going to type in the angle symbol, which is like the less than symbol. And then I type in my angle. So this is just telling it, relative to that last point, I want a length of 5. The angle symbol lets AutoCAD know I'm about to give you an angle. And then you type in 45. You press enter. And you press it. They both do the exact same thing. They're just two different ways to get it done. So that is the difference between dynamic being on and dynamic being off. Typically, now that we have dynamic out there and available, it's definitely a lot easier to use. You just have to remember to press tab when you're going back and forth between angles and lengths. You would press tab to go back and forth. Or if you type in something here and you type in a comma, notice what's going to happen. It's wanting me to type in an angle, but if I press in a comma, AutoCAD jumps and says, oh, you were just giving me an X value instead of a length, so now I'm going to prompt you for the Y value. So now we can type in the Y value, 6, press enter, and that made it, again, relative to this point, it went over and up. And that's it. That is the dynamic input, and again, you can turn that on and off easily with just hitting the F12 function key on your keyboard.